Hello, welcome to EarthSign, and the update just loaded, and let's see what's new. So, basically we have a lot of new changes that will mostly affect the atmosphere of the game. And for that we need to go to the safe house and prepare for the next mission. So, first of all, this adds armor and stability. And that's 10 armor, that's not worth it. I think this should be more than 10 armor, because the boots give 55 armor, and the... I think there is a small problem here, because the helmet gives kind of a weak armor compared to the boots, and it really cuts down on the immersion side of the game. Don't know what to think about that, I don't really like it. How much armor do we have now? Yeah, that's not a lot. That's 73, we can also use the chain boots, that's 74. So, with the helmet actually giving 10 armor flat bonus, you get less armor in total. So, the Kevlar helmet was debuffed. I don't think this was their intention, because they said they will buff the helmets and all the items. Well, don't know what to say, let's see what else they have changed. So for that we'll just do the... Actually, let me see, where is the hunting... A scouting veteran mission. Yeah, this is what we want to do. And other changes included to the spiders and blood crawlers, which will make now sounds when they crawl under the doors, and the ghouls should be acting a little better now. And the blacklight, the famous blacklight problem should be fixed right now. Well, I don't think they're fixed, but we'll try to find at least two trails to see if the problem is really fixed or not. And as a little side note, this is a big update for the game. I mean, when you see a game that is updated according to the player base, that's the best sign you can get. And also, for such a cheap game, they're adding content, well, not exactly content, but fixing the problems in a very, very rapid way. I think chapter 2 will be released in the next year, in February or something like that. Let's listen to the owls. I don't think you have noticed the bird sounds. They can be quite scary sometimes. So okay, we'll just sweep the house and kill everything that moves. So I will complete this mission, because I've done so many missions on camera. Okay. By the way, this is a sound note. See? Don't even have to be near it. Okay, let's see what's in here. That's an electromagnetic clue, by the way. So, the sound design in this game is pretty much on point. And it's great, okay? It's most likely here. Yeah, that's what I thought, and it's... let's see. Also have two shadow beasts here right now. Well, I almost hit him. Okay, so this mission is becoming a lot more scary now. So the blacklight trail was perfect this time. I could actually skip ahead a bit and go right to where it ends. Okay, this could be a blacklight too. No. Any more blacklight clues here? No. There's not a black light. Okay, we're mostly done with this part of the mission. Okay, I think it's under the bed. Yeah, so I think the black light issues are pretty much fixed right now because they improved the algorithm a lot. If nothing else, they are very, very easy to find right now because you can actually see their trail. Now let's see where it starts. Yeah, check this out. You can see the footprints leading out the door. So you don't really need to use the black light anymore as if you find a body. Yeah, the stability bonus is nice and I guess it's okay right now because giving a flat bonus and stability means it would be more useful in the early game, but at the same time I just can't stop wondering if they made the right choice by giving it. I panicked there a bit. Okay, I'm pretty much fed up with spiders at this point. Let's see how much damage they do to me. Well, they're actually doing decent damage. Because the armor cap for this... Okay, so now I'm thinking about the next thing. If this is the armor cap and I'm receiving only 25% of the damage, how will that scale in the next chapter? Because in the next chapter, they have to deal a lot more damage, meaning you'll be forced to use armor because they deal quite a lot of damage even now. Yeah, so the trail is a bit further and it's also easier to spot. But I wanted to see the ghouls. Give me a ghoul. Okay, spiders once more. Okay, so spiders and no ghouls. Come on, I really want a ghoul. I want to pet him and hold him and say I love him. Okay, so no ghouls. This time we have to come back again to see how the ghouls react. But we did manage to see a lot of cool stuff right now. Okay, let's leave the job. And even though the devs... Actually, they said they will take a break until next year because they were so busy making the game and the dev team is so large that all 2 members of the dev team needed a vacation. So I guess it's okay that they're still releasing these small updates and fixes, and again, it's all based on the Steam discussion page. Because this is not very used, but again, since forums and blog posts and all that is not really mainstream media anymore, and even Facebook is not mainstream media anymore for big companies, because people have a very, very, very low attention span on Facebook, and they almost never communicate things like this, well, unless it's a very big game. But believe me, if you want to learn more about the game and see how the devs react to your ideas, just go on the Steam discussion page, because they answer every topic almost. This has the smell of a ghoul in it. Actually, there's spiders. Okay, let's reload a bit. Okay, let's put a trap right here. Just in case. Oh, I forgot to show you the rebalanced nook volley gun. Okay, let's go back and take that for a spin. Sorry about loading and reloading, guys. There are a lot of strange sounds in the air tonight. Because they said they rebalanced the Nuke gun, and that gun was terrible, I mean... Wow. Easy. Okay, let me see. Do I have any accessories for the shotgun? Of course, I have a scope for the shotgun. Yeah, that's because I don't have the perk to use shotgun attachments. Actually, let's use the red dot, because I think we'll reload the gun a lot more than we used to. And also, I need some buckshot. UV buckshot. The new gun is very hard to produce, I mean, it's not that hard, but it's not really worth it, and that makes it double as hard to produce. Ooh, it's shiny. I like how they are looking. And I'll just equip them right now. They look amazing. They look like magic bullets. Okay, now let's have some real fun. So the new gun was basically like a gen cannon that could one-shot ghouls and bigger creatures, but at the same time, it has such a huge knockback that it was almost dangerous to use, because you could get knocked off in the wrong direction and trigger another monster invasion. And that would have made your job a lot harder to do. So I used it on a mission and, well, it does the damage, but it doesn't do anything else for you. Let's see how it is now, because looking at the stats, I can't really tell you what's changed. Because they made the shotguns in such a way that you don't really know what's going on with them. By the way, I want to... Actually, let's put some traps here. Because I want to catch the ghoul. Yeah, it's the same ridiculous shotgun as before. Oh. So how was the rebalance made? Is it weaker now? Well, he has some extra sounds. Well, that's strange looking. That's too funny. He has some new sounds, I have to admit, though they're not as game changing as I thought them to be. But I guess I'll show this video to the devs, because that's a bug, and it's a real weird bug, I have to say. By the way, notice the blood splatter pattern. So I shot it right here, and you can see how many pellets it actually shoot. So the blood splatter was here, and also on the wall. And it's a bit strange. Oh well, let's see if we can find another ghoul or spider to play around. By the way, if you want to know how much recoil this has, let me show you. Oh. Sorry, I messed that up. It's very hard to aim your recoil with this gun. Oh, come on, I want to show you the recoil and how far it can go. Let's shoot it right here. This is an escape weapon. It has an instant teleport. So I think it can be useful in some situation, but again, it will cost you a lot of money to use, and again, since that's not fixed... Wait, am I losing HP when I'm hitting myself against the walls? I didn't notice that. Okay, devs, congratulations, you just have made this weapon totally useless now because you lose HP when you hit the walls. So you lose HP each time you shoot it. I don't think, is that intentional? That can't be intentional. Because look at this. I get more damage dealt to me if I fire the gun. Then what's the point of using the shotgun then? Well, I can't say I'm too happy about the update then. Because I get more damage from the actual weapon than the other things. Actually, let's see how the spiders behave. Oh, that's very scary. The door moving and hearing those sounds are quite unsettling, to say the least. So, overall I like the new changes to the game, especially to the spider when they go through a door. And the ghouls seem to be okay. I mean, there's not much of an improvement right there. It's almost the same song. But again, we also got to see some of the new animations that you probably have not seen, including the Shadow Beast attack, the two Shadow Beasts attacking us. So overall, the game is a lot scarier. But why did they do this? Until now, the crafting has been the worst part of the game, and it's still the worst part of the game. I really hope the Nook Shotgun will get that debuff removed or something real, because crafting is so useless in the game right now. I don't know even why they added the magic talisman. Never bothered to make it. The shotgun under barrel and the Uzi. It's a good weapon. I'll probably craft it in the next episode or in another episode. But I crafted the vampiric blood and it's just extra damage at the cost of health and not really worth it in my opinion. Let's see, do I still have that around here or where did I put it? Oh yes, here it is. So you give 50 health away and you get 100% bonus to your damage. But at the same time, you can't use any more healing, so it's a misorder situation. If the gear becomes better or if you want to rush through a poltergeist, it's the thing to use. But again, they're adding things that are too risky to the game right now. And I really hope they redo the whole crafting bit because this is almost ridiculous. I think the revolver is worth it, but I'll craft it next time. So this has been my video review of the update. See you next time, bye bye.